Welcome folks, in this video and over the next also the next few videos we are going to be proving various equalities from the identities and the distributive function of all the other various things which we have learned for now. So let us start with this one. We have to prove that A minus B whole union with A is equal to A, and if you look at it, it is really true, but we'll do it analytically. So if you have to prove that two sets are equal, one of the ways is to prove that like the LHS is a subset of RHS and the RHS is also a subset of LHS, and in that case they both are going to be equal, and that's exactly what we are going to do. So now, since A minus B is a subset of A, and that's actually very obvious, A minus B has to be a subset of A. If we look down at it further, A minus B union something is also going to be A union that something, and now in this case that something is the A itself, but it is something else. So moving further, A minus B union A is a subset of A, because A union A is A itself, and let this be our first conclusion. And again, since we can see that A minus B union A contains A, we can see here it contains A, but it also contains some other elements. Which means that A is a subset of this A minus B, that something union A. And now look, we have proved that A minus B is a subset of A minus B union A is a subset of A, and A is also a subset of A minus B union A. So in conclusion, A minus B union A is actually equal to A. Moving on to the next thing we have to prove, that A minus B intersection B minus A is equal to phi. And if you think about it closely, A minus B and B minus A, they have nothing in common. So now we take the LHS A minus B intersection B minus A, that is equal to A intersection B complement intersection B intersection A complement. And that is basically the definition of what a symmetric difference is. Now, since all our intersections, those brackets don't hold any meaning, so A intersection, let's concentrate on this first, and B intersection B complement. What does B and B complement have common with them? That is a phi. Nothing. They don't have anything in common. And what does phi has in common with any other set? That is phi. And so we have proved our second identity. Moving to the third one. We come at A minus B is equal to A intersection B. And now here we take the LHS A minus B, and that is equal to A intersection A minus B whole complement. And now that intersection is also equal to, so this is what it comes out to be. Moving further, now we apply the De Morgan's law here. This whole intersection A will become its complement, intersection will become union, and B will also become its complement will become its complement, which is B. So using the distributive property, A intersection with A complement union A intersection with B, and A and A complement, they have nothing with common with them. So the answer is A intersection B. And we proved our third question. Now next we have to prove that A minus B is equal to P complement minus A complement. So now taking the RHS, P complement minus A complement, that is equal to P complement intersection A complement complement, which is A itself. Now that's very simple, just reordering the term, and that if you identify is A minus B. And now moving to the last one, we have if A union B is equal to B, if and only if, this like a double implication sign known as if only if, A is a subset of B. And now what this statement means is that if A is a subset of B, then A union B is going to be equal to B, and if A union B is B, then definitely A is going to be a subset of B. And how we prove such type of question is that first we are going to assume that this was what we have, and from there we are going to derive this, and the second part we are going to assume that this is what we have, and from it we are going to derive this. So let us assume that A is a subset of B. This means that A union B is going to be a subset of B union B, and hence A union B is a subset of B. Now if you look at this statement, this LHS, it has the whole set B along with some other elements of the set, some of all the elements of the set A, and that is a subset of B. Actually B is equal to B, and if we add something to B, it won't become a subset. It can become a superset, but it can't definitely become a subset. So hence A union B is going to be equal to B, because that's the only case that can happen. And taking now the next step, now we assume that let A union B be actually equal to B. From this we can see that A is a subset of A union B. A is definitely a subset of it, and this is equal to B, so A is a subset of B. So starting from this we derive this, and starting from this we derive that back. So this means that A union B is equal to B implies in this direction also, in that direction also, that A is a subset of B. Thank you.